NASA's OSIRIS-REx has just arrived at the Bennu asteroid after 2 years of traveling through space. The mission has seemingly gone under the radar for most of the public, as it was not advertised nearly as much as the recent InSight landing on Mars. But I think you'll find this mission just as interesting, if not more so than the InSight lander. So, what will it do there? What are its mission goals? And why is it there in the first place? I'm Alex McColgan, and you're watching Astrum, and together we will go through everything you could want to know about the OSIRIS-REx mission. Let's start from the beginning. OSIRIS-REx is part of the New Frontiers NASA program, along with Juno and New Horizons, which means it's part of a high pedigree if you've been following those other missions. It launched in September 2016 and arrived near Bennu on the 3rd of December 2018, where it has begun imaging the surface. Although Bennu is a near-Earth asteroid, it still took a long time to get there. This is because Bennu does not orbit along the plane of Earth, and its gravity is incredibly weak, which means OSIRIS-REx had to slow down a lot, or it would have simply overshot its mark. Interestingly, the OSIRIS team had a pretty good idea of what Bennu would look like long before OSIRIS-REx even launched. This was because they used radar data to simulate what it would look like. As OSIRIS-REx approached Bennu, the images it sent back were progressively more and more clear, and the OSIRIS team saw that their predictions were surprisingly accurate. Eventually, it got to within 20 kilometers of the asteroid, and what it saw was amazing. This is an actual time-lapse of the Bennu asteroid as seen by OSIRIS-REx. If you compare the simulation to the actual photographs, it's amazing how accurate their predictions were. As you can see, it's not a particularly smooth asteroid, covered with rough regolith all over the surface. It reminds me a lot of the surface of another asteroid that was visited by the JAXA probe Hayabusa, the asteroid Itokawa, which was more like a clump of rubble than anything else. Bennu itself is about 500 meters in diameter, and has this weird spinning top-like shape. This could be because Bennu has a low gravity but a fast rotation, so regolith has accumulated there as it span. Bennu is a carbonaceous asteroid, but in the less common B-type classification. This puts it in the same category as the third biggest asteroid in the solar system, Pallas, and Bennu could even be the ejector from an impact early in Pallas's life. B-type carbonaceous also means it has a very low albedo, or that it doesn't reflect a lot of sunlight. Other tests show it could be an even rarer F-type asteroid instead, and as such, could have been part of the Polana family of asteroid, meaning it came from the 55 km big asteroid Polana. In either case, its orbit has changed significantly through various processes and interactions to bring it closer to the orbit of Earth. Speaking of its orbit, it is one of the most likely asteroids we know of that could impact Earth. Although based off the most recent estimate in 2014, this won't happen until 2175. And even then, there's only a 1 in 2,700 chance of doing so. Before OSIRIS-REx will go in orbit around Bennu, it first needs to see if there are any small moons or debris around the asteroid, so there isn't any risk of a collision. It will do this by going back and forth a few times around the asteroid, also getting a sense of the gravity of an object so small. Once the prime orbit has been located, OSIRIS-REx will orbit roughly 1.4 kilometers above its surface, mapping out the surface of Bennu in detail, looking for differences in minerals across the surface of the asteroid. Interestingly, this means that Bennu will be the smallest world ever to be orbited by a spacecraft. This will last for about 1 year, and what scientists are looking for is the sampling site. You see, unlike most robotic NASA missions that don't return to Earth, OSIRIS-REx will, hopefully carrying samples of the asteroid with it. OSIRIS-REx is unique in that it is a sample return mission, the first time NASA will be doing this with an asteroid. Although it should be noted that JAXA has done this before with the Hayabusa mission, and are currently in the process of doing it again with Hayabusa 2. Once the sampling site has been chosen in mid-2020, OSIRIS-REx will drift extremely slowly towards Bennu to land. This slow speed is to avoid the use of thrusters as much as possible. If the thrusters are used close to the surface, the gas from them could contaminate the samples. The solar arrays will fold into a Y shape upon descent to avoid dust settling on the panels after the impact with the surface, and to provide more ground clearance should the spacecraft tip over. However, the force of the impact should be dissipated by a spring on the arm of OSIRIS-REx. Once it is landed, it will fire a burst of nitrogen gas at the ground, blowing particles up to 2 centimeters into the sample collection chamber in the arm. After 5 seconds, the sample collector will close, and the spacecraft will back away from the asteroid. Scientists are hoping for about 60 grams of material. It will find out how much mass it has in a really clever way. It will do a spin to see the change in inertia with this added weight. If it wasn't able to collect enough samples, it will go in for another try. Should everything go well at this point, the container will be stowed by a robotic arm. By 2023, OSIRIS-REx will eject the sample capsule back towards Earth, where it will be picked up by scientists in the Utah desert. This is when the sample study part of the mission will begin. OSIRIS-REx will continue to orbit the Sun long into the future. But why asteroids? Apart from the curiosity factor, is there anything that actually makes asteroids special? Well, asteroids are remnants of some of the oldest objects in our solar system. They were there when everything was in the process of forming around the Sun. To this end, asteroids can tell us a lot about the formation of the solar system. They are the building blocks of planets, and also potentially life. Asteroids could be the source of water on Earth, and they mysteriously contain organic materials like hydrocarbons and amino acids. Actual uncontaminated samples of asteroids will provide insight into this, enabling us to have a better understanding of the universe we live in. So hopefully this mission will be as successful as its other New Frontier cousins. Well, I hope you had great holidays. Are you like me, wishing they could last a little longer? One of the things I like most about this time of year is the spirit of giving. Well, you don't always need an excuse to give someone a present. If you have a loved one who wants to know more about math, science, or space, I have the thing for you. You can now gift a subscription of Brilliant.org to friends or family. I love this because it's a fun way to nurture curiosity, build confidence, and develop problem-solving skills crucial to school, job interviews, or their career, something which will last well beyond Christmas. Go to brilliant.org/astrum and grab a gift subscription to help your loved ones finish their day a little smarter. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed learning about OSIRIS-REx. If you did, you may enjoy my other spacecraft videos found here. Subscribe so you don't miss out on anything in the future. And if you want to help support the channel, I have Patreon. All the best, and see you next time.